Okay, we're doing two of them, 7 3/8 leave the line. There we go. Okay, now let me show you on the back side what we're doing here. Okay, what I'm doing is I'm getting this flush with the inside of your glass rail. You can see how this, how these are flush with there. But on the front, they're also flush. They're the, where am I? There I am. Flush with the top. Oops. So what you do is you take, once you get everything done and these are set, you want to make sure the back, where am I? The back is flush, because what you can do on the front when you're sanding down the door, you can run your sanding over the edge and get this to where it's the same height as the outside of the door. And what I decided to do, I just went halfway between 3/4 and 1/2 inch. I'm doing 5/8. That way I don't have to make two different sets of mullions. Okay, now we need one that goes from the bottom to the top, and it's the full length. So here, this one is 19 7/16. Yes, that's a good fit. Okay, now here comes the important part. Center this one, which 7 3/8. Oh boy. Well, the way I try to do it, I just put the tape on 7 7 3/8, and then look up there and see what the 7 3/8, and then look up there at the top. It's really 3, and looks like 11 16ths. So we need to come 3 11 16ths from one side to the center, and then from the center to the other side, exact center. Okay, now that we got that one centered, we need to break it in half, or in thirds, because we need our two cross pieces. All right, the way we do that, chop that vertical piece down, take the two centers to where they'll fit in between those two, one there, one here. So you might want to check, like one of them's just a hair bit shorter than the other. So that will make a difference. Okay, now we break this into thirds. So we have to figure out ¼ divided by 3. For just moving right along adjustments, I'm just going to call it 6½, and then move it where you need to. So now we have our grill is in place. So this is where another important part is. Now we're going to dado these in. We'll dado the back side of this, the back side of this, and then we'll dado the front side and the front side, because we want this to fit together like Lincoln logs. because we'll have to make us a jig for our router to fit in there so that we can do some dadoing. Now if you have a radial arm saw where you can put a dado blade on there, that makes quick work out of setting up. But being that I'm in my shade tree garage, we don't have that out here. Okay, we got our marks on there. So now what we need to do is we need to lay our pieces in the center and just put a couple of marks on each side. Get them as close as you can. Okay, there's those two. Then we do the same with the horizontal pieces. Okay, now to get our jig. Okay, I'm getting the jig set up. And what you do, get you a router. And you want to get one side completely nailed in, the other side, put your router on there, push that up against there. Once it's nailed, keep it against this other side, move this one over against it. Now you don't want it too tight. Now I'm not using very good lumber, so don't try to use the same stuff I am. Anyway, put your nail in there. Now you've got your whatever you want to call it, your radial arm router, your router. It's going to have a 5/8 slot in it. You can make these any size you want. If you wanted to, all you got to do is keep this one the same, move this one over, and it doesn't matter how much slop is in here, whatever it moves over is however much you're going to make that slice. So that, I'll show you that in a minute. But right now we just want to get our pieces cut in. And now what we're going to do is we're going to go down half the distance on each one of these so that they'll cross. Okay, we got our slot caught, cut. Now what we do, you remember these marks that you put on here? Okay, this is going to set on your marks. And now you'll have to either put a small nail, you want to try to come to the outside of your piece, to put a little small nail in there to keep it from moving. Now you can set you up a couple of blocks here, which that's what we're going to do. Okay, I'm going to just shoot this down. Let's keep our piece from sliding around. Okay. Get our piece right on top. Anchor this down somehow, screw, nail, something. We've got two scrap pieces here that we're going to do first. Okay, undo that. Okay, what we got here. Oh yeah, well, it's just a hair bit big, but if it's a paintable type mullion, it really won't matter. If it's stained, being that you're using scrap to set it up, you can adjust your guides to where you can get a little closer. But in any case, here we go. We're going to go ahead and run these others. See, you can, before I do that, let me just show you, see how it fits together. Okay, all right, now I got our pieces made, but you know, you should always have a piece of standby in case something like this happens where you blow out the edge. I'm really using two fattest screws. I usually use little skinny ones to hold this on there. But in any case, okay, we got this done.